Fallout series takes place decades after nuclear war riddles the world with radiation, and pretty much the only human survivors are the people who moved into giant underground vaults. Plot elements and ulterior motives aside, could human society really survive decades or even centuries in Fallout shelters like the Vault Tech vaults? Let's pick up a science bobblehead and find out. There are a few different kinds of radiation. In the Fallout scenario, we're concerned with ionizing radiation from nuclear fallout, which is the stream of alpha particles, beta particles, or gamma rays shooting out from unstable atoms. Time, distance, and shielding are the three main factors that affect your chances of surviving ionizing radiation. You want to be exposed for as short a time as possible, be as far away as you can, and have the most shielding. What does that sound like? A fallout shelter. The Vault Dweller Survival Guide, or VDSG for short, provides some stats on Vault 13, which was underground, covered by 200 feet of earth and a 12-foot thick steel door. But what if you live somewhere you can't dig? Here's chemist Rachel Burks.
Since digging 200 feet underground isn't going to work everywhere, what can we do to protect ourselves from the fallout? NASA has developed some radiation shielding for spaceflight, which could be adapted for fallout shelters. Scientists are developing nanomaterials that can resist radiation, high heat, and high pressure. Walls of carbon nanotubes are promising candidates. Current research suggests that carbon nanotubes provide protection from radiation, and ounce for ounce are at least 100 times stronger than steel.
For electronics, which could easily fry under radiation, there's another nanotech called resistive memory, which is made of an electrode-electrolyte sandwich that looks promising. Will it protect us and our gadgets against raiders? Well, that's still in the testing phase. But long-term life in the vaults requires more than just thick walls. You need power, water, and food.
Vaults have limited storage, so fossil fuels wouldn't last you very long. Solar power is out if you're 200 feet underground and don't want death claws ripping up your solar panels. Shoo! Shoo! Different vaults have different power sources. Vault 8 runs on nuclear power, and Vault 13 uses geothermal energy, which uses the heat of the earth to turn water into steam to power generators. Fuel cells could also work. They produce electricity, heat, and water. And unlike batteries, fuel cells don't need to be recharged, as long as they get a constant supply of fuel, like hydrogen.
While in Fallout and Fallout 2, there are cool water chips to purify water, we don't have those. After a nuclear war, irradiated water would be a real problem, with many sources being contaminated. One possible purification method uses graphene oxide to remove radioactive elements from the water.
And how about food? In the VDSG, Vault 13 comes equipped with hydro-agricultural farms to provide food. Today, we use aquaponics for cultivating crops and fish in a closed water system. No soil needed. Like in soil-based farming, the nutrients living things need to survive are cycled through the system. Fish excrete nitrogen, but too much nitrogen can produce ammonia that's deadly to fish. Good news is, plants need nitrogen in order to survive. Put the two together, and the fish provide nitrogen for the plants, while the plants filter the water for the fish. A small-scale nitrogen cycle. Commercial aquaponics operations have raised tomatoes, herbs, tilapia, catfish, and more. So much better than Instamash. Trust me.
So now we have shelter, power, water, and food. Makes for a cozy vault, doesn't it? Now if they can just take care of that rad roach problem, what would you bring to your vault? Let us know in the comments below and be sure to subscribe and give us a like. Because likes never change.